Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. Today the topic of our discussion is the difference between primary and secondary database. First of all, starting with the definition of database. Database is a collection of related data arranged in a way suitable for adding, locating, removing and modifying the data. It is meant for storage, retrieval and also for modification. Now moving into primary database, let us take an example. This is a primary database that is GenBank, and I have typed insulin in this column and selected nucleotide and typed insulin in the search box, and I have got the sequence and I have taken that sequence in the FASTA format. So this is the sequence that is directly submitted by the researcher into this database. Therefore, primary database is a database where experimental results are submitted directly into the database by researchers. It's a storage database or archival database, and there is a chance of high levels of redundancy or duplication. The same sequence, insulin sequence, there are many insulin sequences of maybe slightly different in nucleotide bases. It can be due to sequencing errors, maybe due to some part of vector is also getting into the sequence. Anything can happen, and anything that is submitted will be stored. And that is never changed, and it is given with an accession number. You can see the accession number. The primary data, simply it is a first-hand data. The experimental result is directly submitted to the database, and that is stored forever. Examples include ENA, GenBank, DDBJ, that is meant for nucleotide sequences, and PDB, that is meant for protein data bank, meant for protein structure and protein sequences, amino acid sequences. Now, secondary database. Let's take an example to understand secondary database. So this is a secondary database. This is protein family or PFAM. So secondary database, as the term indicates, it is a database in which the data is derived from the analysis and interpretation of primary database. It's nucleotide sequences, protein structure, etc. So in this PFAM, I have typed insulin in this search box and clicked go, and I got a result page like this. So in this database, we get many details about that particular query. As you can see, this belongs to insulin IGF relaxin family, and it is the sequences from 260 species are there. So there are many things, domain organization, clan, alignments, etc. So I clicked the alignments, then you can see the sequences in various databases, in primary databases are selected, and this is aligned. We have the data. Then I clicked species, and you can see the distribution or the sequences that is submitted to different primary databases of various species that is given in a single window. Secondary databases uses data from primary and secondary databases and also from scientific paper, and that is studied and that is verified and that is clubbed together. So it is a curated database or a derived database. The chance of duplication is very, very low. It's having a high precision. The data in the primary database is selected, analyzed and interpreted and is included in the secondary database. Therefore, for a molecular biologist, once he or she is having a data or a sequence, the main source to move further is exploring the secondary database. It just serves as a reference library or a knowledge base for molecular biologists to carry out the research further. Examples include PFAM, Interpro, Uniport, etc. Hope you got the concept. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com.